Okay, we're sharing the data between all states. So what? How do we use it? Well, the first task we want to do is go to our notify section and notify the user of exactly what passed. So in here, we have the data coming in, which is, of course, is an instance of the type def. Look at that glyph. So in the no error case, we want to go and do something. Maybe just pop up a dialog box to the user telling them if something passed or failed. So let's go ahead and unbundle this. And I'll pull out the basic passed and the basic voltage. Let's keep it really easy and just send a message to the user. I'll hold down control, click and drag to create some space here, because I'll send a message to the user with my one button dialog. And we'll make a message, a string message, create a constant off of this, detach it for now. The basic test and then we'll concatenate on what happened with the select function. If it passed, we'll make a copy of this, click and drag with control. If it's true, passed. We'll want a space in there too. Or failed. We'll use our concatenate strings. Another string with a voltage of, put some spaces in here so it renders correctly. Now, of course, the voltage coming out of here is a numeric, but we're reporting it as a string, so we need to change that. There we go. Number to fractional string. Voltage comes in, and out comes the value. Let's test this little block of code. Look how easy LabVIEW will be to prototype and test. Copy, control N for a new VI, control V. Head to this and say, let's say I have a voltage of 5.5. It passed. Run it. The basic test passed with a voltage of 5.5. Great. This may seem like a little too much data for us. So with our context help, we can take a look at this and say that we probably just want a precision of 2. That's better. Check the prototype. Passes, that looks good, we don't need it anymore. We fixed it here, and we wire that concatenated string into here just to notify the user. We could obviously go and do the same thing for the advanced test, and clearly we can do far more than just send a dialog box. We can write to a file, a database, whatever. We're just keeping it simple. So now, the whole point is in another place, like the basic test, we actually go and fill that value. So in basic test, basic passed will be false, and basic voltage will be 2.6. So let's go ahead and run it. Run it. Basic test, and we get basic test failed with a voltage of 2.60. Great. And back to idle. Now, where else can we use this? Well, clearly in the advanced test, we can fill in the same thing. Also in the error reporting. When it comes time to do the error, it's a good idea to maybe, in the error report, say it was passed and failed, and what the voltage values are, to be able to do some troubleshooting after the system is shut down. Anything else we should know here? Well, keep in mind that we made a type def of our states and of our data. Because now, if I ever go back and need to add more data that I need to pass between states, I just put it in here. I don't even have to change, in most cases, the coding, because this pipeline now grows or shrinks with whatever I put in here. And using the unbundle by name, I can just take out the new items by name. So essential to use that type def for that data cluster. That's all in state machines for now. Remember, this was one of your suggestions. We like those, so keep them coming. And keep coming back to sixclair.com/LabVIEW training. Take our course online, or come visit us at a regional course, or have us on site.